In this video, I am going to explain basic anatomy of these muscles. What are they? They are suboccipital muscles, also known as suboccipitals. There are four muscles. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, they are very, very tiny muscles, but they are so important to maintain head and neck position. Okay, so I will explain one by one. The first muscle is this one. This is rectus capitis posterior minor. Rectus capitis posterior minor. Geez, it's very long name. I know it's very long name. This muscle attaches on occiput and, I change color, C1. Occiput and C1. This is very, very important muscle, so I will explain why this is important later. Okay, so this is rectus capitis posterior minor. If there is minor, there should be major. Where is it? This is it. This is it. This is rectus capitis posterior major. I'm not gonna write it down the whole name. I'm just gonna say major. Rectus capitis posterior major. It attaches on occiput and C2 because it's bigger than the minor. Okay, it's longer and it's bigger than the minor. Makes sense, right? It attaches on occiput and C2 right here. And there are two other muscles. This is oblique capitis superior. Let's say I'm gonna write it down here. Oblique capitis superior. Oblique capitis superior, okay? This attaches on occiput and C1. Simple enough. Oblique capitis superior. The last one is this one. This is oblique capitis inferior. We had superior, so we have inferior. This is very funny because this muscle doesn't attach on occiput, but its name is oblique capitis inferior. It doesn't attach on occiput, but it's just the name that anatomists named it, so we can't help it. You know, this is oblique capitis inferior. So there are four muscles: rectus capitis posterior minor, major, oblique capitis superior, and inferior. These four muscles. But this is from posterior view. If you see these muscles from profile view, they look different. So let's move on to the profile view. Okay, this is profile view. They look much different, right? This is rectus capitis posterior minor. This is major. And this is oblique capitis superior. And this is inferior. They look much different, right? Especially oblique capitis superior and inferior are very different from the posterior view, right? Let's go back to the posterior view again. This is posterior view. Much different. Let's move to a profile view. See, much, much different. So in anatomy book, most likely they show you the posterior view, but important thing is profile view, because you can see the relationship, the anatomy, like three-dimensional direction of these four muscles. Okay, why are they so important? Because these muscles are very, very tiny, because you can compare to this cartridge of ear. You know, compared to these cartridges, you can see the size of four muscles. They are very tiny. How come they are so important? Because these four muscles include proprioception so many proprioceptions. What is proprioception? It is like a balance sensor of joint and the whole body. So if this muscle gets tight, the proprioception cannot function very well. What is proprioception? It's balance sensor. If this system is aggravated, it's very hard to maintain the head and neck position. This place is very important to maintain the eye level or head position. So if this place is aggravated, that can create headache or neck tightness, so many things. That's why this place is very, very important. Now, let's move on to the final part of this video. I'm going to focus on one tiny muscle. Okay, even the closer view, I'm going to focus on this one. This is rectus capitis posterior minor. Why is that so important? The key tissue is this one. This is atlanto-occipital membrane. Atlanto-occipital membrane. This membrane is very important because in these two tissues, there is fascial connection. They are connected via the fascia. Okay, it's very cool, right? Even more. And this membrane has connection with the dura mater of spinal cord. Imagine there's spinal cord inside, and this blue one is dura mater. Okay, now this membrane has connection with dura mater of spinal cord. It's very, very interesting. So if you can approach to rectus capitis posterior minor, you can approach to dura mater of spinal cord indirectly. I'm not saying there's direct fascial connection between muscle and dura mater, but this membrane is kind of the bridge in between muscle and dura mater. That's why this membrane is so important. Also, the muscle is important as well. I'm going to explain this relationship again, okay? So this is a muscle, rectus capitis posterior minor. This is atlanto-occipital membrane. And there is dura mater of spinal cord inside. There's fascial connection between this muscle and membrane, like this, right here. Also, this membrane has myofascial connection with dura mater. That's why if you can approach to this muscle, you can affect to dura of cervical spine. This is very, very important. So in this video, I explained basic anatomy of suboccipital muscles. They are very, very tiny muscle, but very important to maintain head and neck and eye positions. Plus, I explained important myofascial connection with dura mater. I hope this video helps your understanding of anatomy. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.